A very good morning and welcome to yet another vlog here on the Theme Park Worldwide YouTube channel. We've just got back literally from the airport and our fantastic trip out to Fantasyland, where we went to experience Klugheim. Whilst we were out there, it was announced that Derren Brown's Ghost Train has now soft opened, technically, meaning that it's now open to the general public to go and experience. Now, Derren Brown's Ghost Train was supposed to open back at the start of May 2016, but yeah, today's the day where we're going to go and get to ride this wonderful new dart ride at Thorpe Park. Are you excitedly to derail your mind?
Very excited.
Hopefully, you know, today's going to be the day. Like I say, it is technically soft openings. It's not 100% guaranteed, but today hopefully is the day we're going to get to do it. Now, please be aware that this vlog will contain spoilers. I am going to be talking all about the experience and exactly all the details on what happens inside Derren Brown's Ghost Train. So if you don't want the surprise to be spoiled, then do not watch this vlog. If you don't mind spoilers, then like I say, check it out. The spoilers won't begin straight away. Obviously, there's going to be some shots outside the attraction and things, so I will give you another spoiler warning in a few minutes' time when we actually get to ride the Ghost Train itself. Now, of course, there's rumours going around that this attraction is the most expensive ride that Merlin Entertainments, the owner of Thorpe Park, have ever built. And of course, what we know is that Derren Brown has been heavily involved in this fantastic new experience. I personally cannot wait. We know it features VR, we know it features special effects, and we know it features live actors. But apart from that, the secrets have been kept pretty strong with this one. We don't really know the details of what we're going to experience inside Thorpe Junction. So I'm really, really excited. We're just a few miles away now, so let's head down to Thorpe Park and we'll see you at the entrance. It's going to be a really good day. Are you excited, Lee?
Yes, very excited.
Derail your mind. Derail it.
No spoilers from me.
Spoilers. Okay, so we are now here at the entrance to Derren Brown's Ghost Train, where we've been waiting for approximately an hour and a half so far. We're waiting here without any sort of announcements or anything like that. However, a small queue has appeared at the ride entrance. Did you see it? Hey, give us a wave at the back. Yeah, Theme Park Worldwide on YouTube. There you go. And then literally 5 minutes ago, we had an announcement from the ride staff saying they hope to open it within the next 30 minutes for technical rehearsals. We've also had a member of staff come down here to the entrance and briefed an entrance host, sort of explaining that what's going to be happening. So it looks like we're finally going to get to ride the Ghost Train. Excitedly.
Yes,
well, I will be excited once I'm through the gates.
As soon as the baggies all open, we'll do the gates.
As soon as the gates open, then I'll
What about you, Chris?
I can't wait. I came here on Wednesday and thought, you know what, I'll give it a risk. I'll give it a
risk it for a chocolate biscuit.
Yeah, but that chocolate biscuit wasn't very good. So I've come back today.
So it's come back today for a digestive. So there we go. Hopefully we're going to get on. It's looking really good. Soundtrack's obviously playing outside. We've had lots of presence of staff all around the area. And I must say, I'm quite impressed with the ride uniform. I think they look really good, the staff. And I can't wait to go inside. Like I say, from this point on, this vlog will contain spoilers. I'm going to be coming out and I'm going to be telling you everything about the inside of this attraction. So if you don't want any spoilers, you want to turn this vlog off now, as it is not for you. That is a pre-warning. I know there's been a lot of you out there that have kept away from spoilers, so you might want to skip this one, because literally I'm going to tell you about every single little detail inside this attraction. Let's go, and I'll keep you updated here at Derren Brown's Ghost Train.
Thank you.
Here we go. The gates are opening.
Not quite.
Hey! Whose ghost train is it?
My ghost train!
Perfect.
Here we go, we're in the ghost train.
2 months away, we're here.
This is the moment we've come for. It's not very often here in the UK we get a mega new dart ride, and now is the time to finally get on and experience what Derren Brown's Ghost Train really has in store for us. There we go. I love dark rides, I love themed experiences, so hopefully with this one, we're in for something quite special. The atmosphere's electric, this is it. This is it, Derren Brown's Ghost Train at Thorpe Park.
The atmosphere here is amazing right now.
This is what we love. We're in the queue lines, have a look what we've got. Audio again by Imascore. Starting to derail our minds. Obviously the camera can't come inside on this one, but once we come out, we'll give you a complete in-depth review of this brand new attraction. Chris is excited, Lee's excited, this is it!
Finally going.
The
train is finally about to depart.
This is the photo point.
We have one photo point, just not a photo point right now.
Not in operation at the moment.
Better I'll get one in bed.
Hopefully that will open later on. Whose ghost train is it? Always got his souvenir.
Stop the non-existent photo. Hang on.
Wrong ride, Chris. No, seriously, this ride's had a lot of hype and there's been a lot of build-up for this, and we've been watching the construction. We came here early in the year and saw the facade, and look at that facade. If the theming is anything like the shop and the facade, then I think we're in for a treat inside here. Down the bottom there. Little cogs, little chains. No water, no future, no fracking. She's happy now, she's in the vlog. This ghost trail, come all the way from Germany for this. Come on.
What time is your flight this morning?
Ghost train!
Ghost train!
We will see you guys when we come out of Derren Brown's Ghost Train. I can't believe it, we're actually going on! Whose ghost train is it? Ghost train! Let's go, we'll see you afterwards. Oh my god, I can't believe we're going on.
My ghost train.
So we've literally just come off Derren Brown's Ghost Train, and wow, what an absolutely fantastic experience that was. Now this ride has obviously had a lot of hype surrounding it. Obviously it's a couple of months late, but I can see why this ride has had so many problems now. Again, I'm going to give you a little bit of a spoiler warning here. This is going to contain spoilers about Derren Brown's Ghost Train here at Thorpe Park. I'm going to tell you all about it. So basically, as soon as you enter, of course you've got the luggage area out the front just there. You'll put your bags into the holes, you'll get your wristbands. Standard is what you get on other rides. Just trying to stay out of the way because I don't really want to spoil it for anybody who's waiting to go on the ghost train. Set out the corner out of the way. So basically from there, You then head inside into the first pre-show room. Inside there, you've got some projections at the top. You've got some nice ambient lighting, and then you've got a chair which is just there. And then you've got like the little model of the actual train carriage itself, the one they've used on all their marketing. After that point from there, you then, Derren Brown magically appears, and he sort of describes all our different fears, how we're scared of the dark, how we're scared of clowns, etc. And sort of moves into, you know, sort of how we are scared of all these different things. Then a light sort of pops, and then there's all sorts of different sort of effects what go on with him, really, how he's sort of talking. It's quite minimalistic, but not a hell of a lot going on either. You got some nice lighting effects, some nice noises of like some smashing and some screams in the distance. Nothing too scary. And then he says how you're going to enter inside his ghost train and how it's different to anything else you've ever experienced. Then Derren Brown, it's a really nice sort of hologram actually. You've got the actual theme in there, but there must be like a thin sort of curtain what they project onto. It was very, very cleverly done, this hologram of Derren Brown himself. So at that point, they're not really trying to immerse you into anything. He's just warning you and telling you about what you are going to experience. From that room, you then walk into the next sort of scene, walk up some steps. There is also an elevator in there as well for people with limited access, and then you walk into a room where it's literally a bit of theme, a bit of ropes hanging from the ceiling, like a little console on the right hand side, which sort of like acts as a piece of theming, just random bits of things really. As you walk around from that corner, you then head into the main room itself, which is obviously what is inside the main building itself for the ghost train. It's a massive building. A lot of us thought, what could there be actually inside? So as soon as you turn that corner, you're straight into the room, and there it is, hanging from the chains, the actual ghost train itself, and then you'll see the old-fashioned train carriage. From this point in, you've got ambient lighting all the way around. Obviously it's hung from the chains from the ceiling. From this point, you've got projections on the walls, what sort of show how light is seeping in, basically. Not actual projections, sort of well sort of themed lighting. As you can tell, I'm trying to reel off my memory of having a ride on it just here and everything that goes on. So I might have missed a couple of bits, but these are the main things that sort of shined out for me. You got really ambient sort of audio, nothing too much going on in there. And then you get actually led onto the train. There is a bridge that connects the walkway you've come in, taking you onto the train. And then as soon as you step inside, you think, hang on a minute, this isn't an old Victorian style train carriage. You actually end up inside a London Underground tube train. From this point, you've got the virtual reality headsets, which are all hanging from the ceiling. You have to sit down, put your headset on. Now, similar to Galactica, however, they're a bit more advanced. They've got massive speakers attached to the side, quite tricky to actually put on, that I found. Then there's a message on the screen which tells you to adjust your headset. From that point in, the video then begins, and you start your journey into Derren Brown's ghost train. Basically, you're traveling along a tube line, and then you basically fracking is going on basically on one of the tube lines. And this is what I sort of felt from the story. From this point, then an old, well, it's obviously a very different sort of experience for different people. For the first time, I had an old man that was stood in front of me, and I have some of the friends who I went on with, of course, they had an old lady, that one of them had a young teenager who used like a little candle to sort of gain some light in there. It's so hard to sort of think about it all, and I'm just blown away, to be honest, by the amazement of that attraction and how much they've done. After that, then, you'll sort of see how you're sort of going down this tube line, and you're warned about the fracking that is taking place. From that point in is where it starts to get a bit more intense. Obviously, with the virtual reality headsets, you can look left, you can look right, you can even turn your head and look behind you, and it's very, very realistic. The quality of the VR, I thought, was a lot better than what is found on Galactica. Obviously, it's been done by Figment Productions, the same company that have done Galactica, so they've been very busy this year, Figment. But I think the VR, you know, was really, really good. It was a lot better. Still not amazing high quality that I'd like to see in the future, and I'm sure will happen, but it was a lot better quality than what is found on Galactica. Also then, from that point is where it starts to get quite intense. You'll sort of see how this guy disappears. You then crash, basically the train sort of crashes in. You got all sorts of effects and things around, and you stop at the end, and then you've got like the sparks and things all on the VR, sparks all coming down. It's absolutely fantastic from that point. Then you're told to take your headset off and get off the train. At this point, you're then in like a tube station, all the ceilings thing. This is actually real, not just VR. All the surrounding, you've got the screen, the ceiling, sorry, which is all well themed, like an actual tube station would be. You're then told to put your hand over your mouth so you don't get sort of poisoned by the dangerous gases. And then you actually walk into what is like an interchange, what you'd expect on the London Underground, various different tracks, and there's a couple of tube trains there as well, and there's actors running about in there telling you, you need to cover your mouths, quick, we need to get you out, and then a brilliant scare, a tube train actually comes towards you, and then bam, stops, just there, all sorts of smoke effects, and then from that point on, you have to get back onto the train. As you get back onto the train then, you go through a different door, in which we actually, I'll tell you a bit about how the secrets behind how it works in a second, from what we believe, our theory anyway, I'll get Mr. Lee Wood involved. And then from that point, you're back on the train, headsets back on, and then you carry on your journey. From that point in, you have a massive set of effects from there. You've got all the actual train carriage sort of explodes with fire effects. You've got more actors on the train. You've got a massive monster that sort of comes out of nowhere. I'm not too sure where he fits in, but a massive sort of monster comes out. And then there's actors grabbing your legs, grabbing your arms. Basically, they tell you, they warn you to stay seated on there with how sort of intense that actually is. So you want to remain seated. If you're scared, keep your eyes closed. And then from that point on, you have a massive explosion at the end. Dan Brown counts down, 3, 2, 1. That's the end of the ride. And then bam, you get one final scare. This big monster comes on in front of you. What an amazing experience that is. Like I say, that's just me going on for the first time. There's lots of things that I missed there, lots of details. But there's a lot of, that's the main basis of what that ride is. You're going inside, you get on an old train. You're not on the old train, because you're actually in a tube train, and then you come off the tube train, you're not on the old carriage anymore, fracking's taking place, dangerous gas, back on the tube train to escape, giant monster tries and gets you. That's the basic gist of that. Let's get Mr. Lee Wood, and we'll talk more about the technical side of Dan Brown's ghost train.
My ghost train.
So as promised, me and Lee have a theory, don't we, Lee?
We've kind of worked out how we think.
And yes, I'm journey into your mind.
We've kind of worked out how the magic works.
We think anyway, this could be wrong, but
this is what we think. Now we're in the Victorian carriage. You see the Victorian carriage from the start, and then after you've been on the Victorian carriage, you end up in a different room in a tube train. Well, how does that work, you say? Well, we think the tube train is inside the Victorian carriage.
So basically the Victorian carriage is a shell with a track inside with a tube train.
This is the Victorian carriage. And inside the Victorian carriage is the tube train, and the tube train will then go out
on a track
to the next section. And then the next tube train will come in and will come into the tube, into the Victorian carriage.
That's got to be how it's worked.
That's the only way we can describe how we think.
Obviously, when you come off that tube train, then as you've rushed off because of the problem, what's happened, we then believe that once you come back around that scene, you jump on another train at the other side, which then takes you back, rocks a bit, and then back into
back
the train.
Into the Victorian
so it's probably carriage. Running on three trains.
Yeah.
That's
how we think it works.
It's a theory.
We've
that's
tried
what we
looking
think.
Around the ghost train to see if we can see anything, if it's a hologram or anything, but no, it is an actual train.
100%.
The tube train is definitely got
and
to
it's on a track.
And it's on a
100%
track.
100% on a track. Yeah. So basically we're saying it moves out of the carriage.
It's very well hidden, the track. You can't see no track. We tried looking at the side to where we think the track is. You can't see anything. But
it's got to be that.
That's the only way we
can. Another thing to note, and why we think that as well, is when you come off and you rush down to try and escape, you'll notice the curved ceiling. You come out on the left-hand side of the curved ceiling.
We've worked out your mystery.
And then when you get back on, you then have...
He's
not, we've worked him out, we think, anyway. There's probably been watching this from Thorpe Park and they're laughing and saying no, but I think along those lines, that's how that works.
I think that's how it works.
Is it groundbreaking technology? No, but it's a fantastic ride and a lot better than we were expecting, isn't it? So
brilliant.
There we go. The secrets revealed. Dan Brown's Ghost Train.
Yeah, I'm not going to laugh like
So after three rides on Derren Brown's Ghost Train, I can safely say that this is an absolutely fantastic experience ride for Thorpe Park. It's something very different for this country, and overall it combines virtual reality, fantastic theming, a really nice soundtrack, and live actors all into one very universal style attraction, and it's something we've not really seen in the UK before. It's fantastic and a really good experience, well worth coming down here to check out. And as I said in my detailed review earlier on before we had the other ride just, that is really a very special ride to have here in the UK. So I've got Mr. Lee Wood with me then. He's going to tell you a little bit more about the merchandise. I've had a little look around the shop before in past Thorpe Park vlogs earlier in the year, but Lee's got something very special to share with us today.
Welcome to the Lee Wood Ghost Train gift shop.
What have we got?
Today's special offer.
Okay.
The Derren Brown Ghost Train, the levitating train.
There you
yours
go.
To own for just £50.
50 quid?
50
it's got to do something special for 50 quid.
Yes, it's very levitating.
What do you mean it's levitating? Have you got one to show me, maybe? Yes.
Here's one I made earlier.
Oh, Blue Peter quote. Oh, there we go.
Ta-da.
That. What I made
it. So it uses a magnet to levitate a ball. Mains operated, you just plug it in.
It's got some little LED light.
Is Lee going to be purchasing that?
Yes, that will be coming to my theme park room.
Theme park room, not quite a shed, but
no, better.
Still better.
It's almost as better as it's better than a shed.
What else have we got then in here? Of course, some of my favourites are just hoodies. Derren Brown Ghost Train hoodies, you got the teddy bears down there. Of course, this shop's very interactive, like I showed you earlier in the year. You got Derren Brown himself. And yeah, when you try and grab things, the sensors underneath. Very clever, much like the effects in the ride. Got the mug. We're purchasing that, like I said, when I was here in the year. I don't mind the merchandise until I've experienced the attraction. Now that I've been on the attraction and I absolutely love it, I think it's time to buy some merchandise for the Ghost Train. So. There we go, close up with the mug. Derren Brown's Ghost Train on the back. And you've got the suspended train carriage, which of course has the tube train inside there. The shop's great though, really nice and themed. What's that you got there, Lee?
Also to purchase, a
couple of resins.
Two trains you can buy. This one is the resin.
The smaller resin, of course, like the Swarm and Stealth
one. Priced at £8.
£8, of course, annual pass discount.
Annual pass discount is available. 20% off. So that's for that train.
The small one, the small suspended train carriage. Oh, look at that, that's a big boy you got there, Lee.
We have the bigger version.
Wow. Now, I must admit, oh, that's it slided off. Look at that.
You can see my
view,
it is.
So I'll take it off.
And how much is that?
This one, my friends, is priced at. The unlucky number.
£13.
But you get a discount.
You get your discount.
Merlin. 20% Merlin discount.
There you go. Bargain. Of course, lots of other items in here, and like hoodies and necklaces and loads of different things that you need. You can also get your unique Derren Brown card, so you put your money in here and then Derren Brown does a little speech. You got all the little details, like look at this along the walls, and this shop is probably the best shop that Merlin have ever built. Look at all the little details at the top.
Come closer. And I will journey into your mind.
Thanks, Derren. These are a really nice t-shirt just here with all the sort of mechanics on it. And what I like, of course, it keeps the ride very secret. With this shop, it doesn't really have any merchandise, what gives the game away. Obviously, you've watched this vlog up to this point, you know what the game is with this ride. And it is an absolutely fantastic experience, it really is. This is really cool. So this actually turns round. So there's a brick wall and that spins, which is a nice little effect.
Seen this one that is also available in the gift shop.
What we got, Lee?
It is.
It's like a time. What do you call them?
Time scale?
Snow globe?
No, oh, there we go. Look at that. Mind the gap.
Anyway, I'm not too sure what it calls.
I know what it is, but I don't know what it is.
I can't think of what it calls.
And how much
it
is it, Lee?
But. It's supposed to. It doesn't work. That's supposed to go up.
Maybe you think the dodgy one.
Maybe we've got a dodgy one.
Either that or it's not supposed to do it. Another mug, end of the line. Are we getting that? A couple more t-shirts, a bag. There we go. Loads of different items available in a really, really nice theme shop. You can also buy some Derren Brown books.
and DVDs here as well.
Books, wherever you're from in the country.
However you pronounce it.
Penn and Teller. What a brilliant gift shop. Look at that. A brilliant gift shop for a brilliant ride. Down Brown's Ghost Train.
The train now departing platform 1 is the Thorpe Park Express. Please ensure you have all the loose articles and belongings with you at all times.
Spit it out. My ghost train.
My ghost train.
It's ours. It's going to have a trouble
ride of the day then, and time for our fourth ride on Derren Brown's Ghost Train. I was not expecting to come here today and get four rides on the Ghost Train. I thought we'd be lucky to get one, never mind four. So like I say, it's been fantastic. I'm going to go in this time and try and look out for any more additional effects that I might have missed so I can share them with you guys. Obviously, there's a lot going on, there's a lot to take in. on YouTube, and with my review earlier on, I kept going on with it, you know, I want to get inside and just list off a few more effects, what I might have missed earlier on. So let's get inside. Hashtag no fracking. Let's go.
Train.
So after having a fourth ride then on Derren Brown's Ghost Train, I'm really starting to understand a lot more about what this ride's about. I was talking a little bit about the little bits of effects and things that are inside the Ghost Train, and with that one I noticed a few more little things about and exactly why we're going down fracking. Basically, you can sort of, I had an old lady this time, another different old lady than what I had before, and she explained a lot more as why we were going down there. She was just having a regular ride on the tube and she wasn't very happy the fact that they were down in the tube tunnels trying to basically, you know, and there's gases down there. She's saying you don't need to be down there, but they carry on doing it and it's releasing all these gas and it's changing us as people, and that was really, really good. Every single person I've had has had a dog what's come on there, which is quite good. We have like a little dog sound effects in your right ear and the dog just comes on, which is really good. A few people have asked me, I've been doing updates obviously on Theme Park Worldwide Facebook and Twitter pages today, so drop us a like and a follow. But basically I've been on those. A lot of people have asked, is it doable with glasses? I did try my glasses on two of the rides, and then on the other two I didn't. Yes, you can, but it's quite a bit of a faff to sort of get the goggles to sit on your glasses. Obviously you've got the main goggles themselves, which are quite thick, they're not just like a standard pair of glasses. And of course you've got the two big sort of earphones on the side as well. So obviously, can you wear glasses? Yes, you can, but they try and get you, obviously due to the nature of it and trying to rush you on and off the train, part of the theme, then obviously, you know, I'd probably recommend if you can see without your glasses, take them off. Of course, some more things I noticed in there. A lot more smoke effects. When this tube train comes ploughing towards you out of the tunnel, basically they're trying to say, right, we're going to evacuate you, we're going to get you through this tunnel. However, you don't go through the tunnel because the train comes in, the tube train, so you go onto a different line and jump on that train. Little things that I noticed as well about that. There was like a board at the top, so you know when it sort of says how many different, what time the trains and things are coming for the tube, basically that had a little sign on it and that was just saying how, you know, services have been suspended. The little touches like that I really like. My favourite special effect in that though is in the floor, What they've added inside the floor is cracks, and it's literally just got like an orange light underneath which he's flashing, with smoke rising up from underneath. I think that's a really nice visual effect that works really well on that ride. Yeah, what a brilliant attraction Derren Brown's Ghost Train is. I'm going to ask the other guys what they thought of it, and obviously give you their sort of review. Whether they'll contain spoilers or not, I'm not too sure, but if you have watched a whole of this video, you'll know that there has been spoilers inside. So Lee, what do you think as an overall experience to Derren Brown's Ghost Train?
Brilliant, absolutely incredible. Definitely very universal style.
It is very universal, isn't it?
For someone like that to be in England.
Yeah, definitely.
What's your favourite part?
All of it. I think definitely the live scenes.
That's good.
I prefer the live scenes more than the VR, but it needs a little bit more live scenes. But
yeah, the live scene in the, obviously in the middle, you've got the live scene, which is basically where the tube train comes plowing towards you. You've evac'd off that train, you're about to be evacuated through that other tunnel, and then, whoa, the tube train comes in and you're straight on that other train. It's very, very unique. And obviously with that sort of ride, it's always developing. We've been speaking to a few of the management team here today at Thorpe Park, and they've been saying how this ride is still in the testing stage. It's going to be developed, there's more to come. We could see more with the VR, we could see more in terms of effects, and it's going to be an ongoing project. So if you do come to Thorpe Park, bear in mind the ride has not officially opened. It is just soft opening previews. So don't expect to come here just yet and 100% get on it. Also, if you do get on it, don't 100% expect the full experience. There could be techies around in the ride, that sort of thing. Don't come in and expect the full thing to work 100%. This is a very technically advanced ride, especially for the UK. And there's a lot of stuff combined together. I don't think there's another attraction in the world that's combined everything else together like this has. Yes, there's been attractions with VR. There's been attractions with various different elements. You're right there, Lee. But combining everything, then Derren Brown's Ghost Train really does it. What are you buying now? What's he got?
Buying another
ghost train.
Buying another ghost train.
So you've got the levitating train, you're getting that one.
I'm going to buy that one.
And how much is that, Lee? Treat yourself.
£38, but then you get 20% discount.
We knew when we came here a few months ago and saw the shop, this was going to be a great ride. But yes, like I say, some of the details in there are absolutely fantastic. And then we'll go and catch up with Mr. Franklin. Where's he going? Mr. Franklin! Hello! Can I have your review of Derren Brown's Ghost Train?
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10? What's your favourite scene in there? Bear in mind, I've told them spoilers are in there. So.
Probably the... Oh, tough decisions. I think the finale scene's the weakest.
Yeah.
And then the other two, the rush from the train to the first... The
so
middle
they've got live action
really
scenes.
Yeah,
so
the live action's really good.
Yeah, it's really
but
good
the VR
scene.
In Fantastic. The first part's quality as well, so...
Yeah, the VR's great. So have you had a few different experiences, have you, with the VR?
It's been different every time on the first half. No variation on the second yet.
Yeah, one thing we noticed with the finale, it is... the finale, you know, it's just the same at the moment. They are saying there's two endings. We don't know yet, we've not seen it. We'll wait and see. Do you like it, Mr. Michael Broad?
I think it's probably one of the best rides here in the UK. If you come down to Thorpe Park, make sure you check out this attraction. It's brilliant. 10
I'm
out of 10.
Loving the Mickey top as well. Mickey Mouse 1928. There you go. Still not as good as Mickey Mouse, but you know, it's a very, very good attraction. And yes, this is the closest thing the UK's got to a Universal / Disney style ride. And it's hopefully this is the future for Merlin, and we're going to see more dark rides and more experienced attractions. Thorpe Park is well known throughout the whole of the country for its world-class roller coasters. It was about time that this park got a dark ride, and a lot of you might remember back in the day the Wicked Witch's Haunt, and which unfortunately did burn down. But yes, we have got. Is that how long ago it was? There you go. Why is it? He's got the facts, Mr. Broadhouse. And obviously, Wicked Witch's Haunt. I remember doing it as a kid, and since then, this park has lacked an indoor dark experience, and Derren Brown's Ghost Train is absolutely excellent. The hologram at the start is one of my favourites. Obviously the main sort of scenes. Yes, no longer hashtag unavailable, which is great. It's great, yes. So get yourself 13 rides. You enjoy it as an attraction?
It's the best ride on the park.
You really enjoy it. You see, it's getting great reviews.
Never since all times, it's got to be number one.
But for this park, that's your number one. Oh, here we go. So these are the photos. Look at that. It's like a hologram sort of photo if you move it to the side. And
hashtag.
Thank you, Sean.
There you go. Have you guys enjoyed it?
Yes.
Top reviews?
Yeah.
Anything you'd like to say about it?
To say about the kind of gap between when you're...
The final scene.
Yeah, the final scene where you've got the kind of gap section where the train fills with kind of this green.
Yeah, so you add the big monster what comes on, and then bam, your fire blows up, the train rattles and shakes side to side, which I don't think I've mentioned actually yet. It does sort of shake, which is quite clever.
That's a good job.
And then obviously, like you say, there's a section for about, what, a minute and a half where it's just smoke.
I mean, but most of the time that is. So on the last run that we just had, it's obviously quite a bit better. It's a lot faster.
Yeah.
Which made it seem quite a bit better of as a scene. Which
that was the best ride I had on it, that last one.
Yeah, I think that's the same for everybody here.
Yeah. Like you say, the finale scene, I mean, there's still work to be done. The whole attraction is still work to be done. But I'm just glad. You know how much that I get excited for these type of attractions, especially dark rides. I love them to bits, especially when they're full of water, but you know. Like I say, what an amazing attraction. I was worried that this wasn't going to live up to the hype, but it really does. Darren Brown's Ghost Train here at Thorpe Park. Make sure you do check it out. I hope you've enjoyed our video today. And like I say, yes, I might have told you all the different spoilers in this video today, which has been your choice to watch, but come down here and check it out. Yes, I can explain it, but come and check it out in person. Yeah, it's well worth coming to see the wonderful Darren Brown's Ghost Train. It is a scary experience if you get scared easy, but it's not too bad. Me personally, I flinched a little bit. The actors like grabbing your legs, they grab your arm and stuff, but nothing too much, nothing too scary for me. I do enjoy it, but thank you very much for watching this vlog from Thorpe Park. We'll be back later this year, so come and check out any more improvements to Darren Brown's Ghost Train, and that means it's time to
coup those credits.
Credits! See you later. It's the credits.
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 Darren Brown's
not titles.
Credits. No longer unavailable.
Open.